Ender Sigh. What did I mention about Ender Sigh?
Troubled times are upon us.
It's time, then, is it? Time for what? Explain yourself. My execution, what do you think? You're not with him, are you, though? No, I'd smell his rancid breath on you if you were. You're right. We're not Tazok's lackeys. What's going on here? Ah, you're not. Well, this whole place is dirty to the core. That's what's going on. These aren't your ordinary bandits. They're part Black Talons and part Chill. Chill being a demi-human band, mostly hobgoblins, and led by that creepy smart one, Ordinor Crush. There'd be others elsewhere, like that priest Mullahay sent to poison the mines of Nashkel, set himself up as a kobold god, returned, and legions of the brainless barking fools believed him, ready to do his bidding till death do they part. Mullahay's dead. He's working for Tazok, I understand. Question is, who's Tazok working for? That's a trick, see? Crush and Taraz Kozan, leader of the Black Talons, both think he's getting orders from the Zents, and Tazok doesn't do much to discourage that particular line of thinking. But the Black Talons and Chill are bandit groups, see? They ply the trade routes, avoid the cities. And that's where they go wrong. I'm from the gate, and I can tell you, dead as leather, that the Zentarum aren't behind this. How can you be so sure? The desire for silence isn't the only reason I wear soft-soled boots. I wear 'em so I can tell whose toes I'm treading on. I don't mess with no Zentarum. I pick my enemies, and I mess with one group, and one group only, the Iron Throne. And right as rain, here I am as Tazok's personal prisoner. You do the math. The Iron Throne. Where can I find them? Besides Westeros. Tazok's been making regular visits to the Cloakwood, and that's where I'd start if I were you. There's some documents in that chest that might be worth taking a look at, too. Now go step on some toes, all right? And you can tell them Ender Sigh sent you. Things grow darker here. Darker than I thought possible. In Tazok's tent, I came across a prisoner named Ender Sigh. If he speaks true, and I suspect the documents in Tazok's chest that he mentioned will show he does, the bandits are being played as pawns by a power group called, tellingly enough, the Iron Throne. Tazok's orders are coming from some base of theirs within the Cloakwood, and I have little doubt that it is there that I must journey next if I wish to peel back the next layer of this mystery. Something still seems very wrong in this. It haunts me, dancing endlessly along the periphery of my thoughts. What it is, however, I know not. Well, let's make sense of all this crap we picked up. It's an arrow of ice. We can give this back to... what's her name? Branwyn? We need to identify this. I wonder if we can just rest in here for a while. Or if that would be ill-advised. Potion of Fortitude. Useful? Yeah. Oh wait, he took it. Was he the one... he already had... he was the one I'm looking at. Giving it to himself over and over. This is just regular darts, right? Three. Limited to three. Spell thrust. Yeah, let me write this magic. Done. Oop. Do I have blindness? Easier for me to look at. it in there? Charm person, grease, and color spray. I know I have color spray. There's blindness. Yes, I have a charm person. Color spray. Friends, grease. Yeah, I have all this stuff. Protection skull. Protection from magic. Didn't I throw these in here? Oh, I got the bandit scalps in the scroll case. Oh, this is an error. I did not put those in there. Wait. Oh, no, no, no. Duh. This side is where... Okay, that makes sense. This side is the scroll case. This side is my inventory. I thought I had an error that the stuff was in there when it wasn't. Alright. So I have these three memorized. This is enchantment charm. I don't think... If she... Yeah, I don't think... She could probably use grease. That's done with this. Color spray and grease. She can't use enchantments. I didn't mean to do that. Burning hands, magic missile, protection from evil, petrification, shocking grasp, and shield. Blur, cool touch, identify? Oh, no alignment. Mouse acid arrow, web, sinking cloud. We'll get that started. She can cast two fireballs once we rest, anyway. Alright, so let's see what we can do. Failed. Unacceptable. The only time I... Save scum guys when it comes to this. This time it worked. Mage robe of fire resistance. Is this the one we picked up? Fire resistance plus 20%. Due to the extremely volatile nature of most magic, mage robes of fire resistance are not uncommon among young acolytes and their wizardly tutors. As with other such robes, they cannot be worn except by wizards. I'm not sure if this is what we got, though, if it's... I got a special kind of longbow. It was glowing purple. So I already have... Fire resistance. Okay, so I've got another one. The one I'm wearing. House of my armor class. And my save versus death. Alright. Anything else? Alright, okay. Two more potion of healing. Got six here, five here. Take a look around in here.
As directed.
410 gold. Nice. Empty. Another 340 gold. This is awesome. Here is a potion of magic blocking. We have one of those. Who has the other one? Oh, she did. Okay. Alright, now you... find traps.
Good job.
Haha. Not surprised. This is disarming a trap, I believe. Sweet. 2,060 gold. Holy crap. Some special kind of gauntlets. Let someone who actually has inventory space grab this stuff. Which at this point would be Minsk.
Butt kicking for goodness!
That's not it, Minsk. Okay, we've got a letter.
Mulahay and Tazok have proven to be nothing more than puppets. The true master of this unfolding mystery continues to elude you. One thing is certain. Someone has taken a very personal interest in seeking your death. Though why, you are not sure. Your search for answers continues, and the foreboding Cloakwood Forest is your next target.
Indeed. We haven't read the letters yet. Okay. The investigation of the bandit camp has directed me to Cloakwood. It appears there is a competing iron mine hidden somewhere deep within the... I guess Cloakwood. Kagane says, my caravan's destroyed, and the Silver Shield's pup is dead. Here's a fine to-do. The last of me funds is a kite's breakfast, and me customer ain't gonna be one whit pleased by it. I think we had to go to Baldur's Gate to do that, though, and I wasn't planning on... Or did he just find... Did something run out, or did we just find out about it? Do you suppose there's a connection between these bandits and the Iron Raiders? Nah. We're on ship and no iron. These here jackals must have come snuffling around the blood when them iron crews have shed. In that case, our goals are the same. We can continue to pursue the bandits and their masters together, if you would. So says I. You'd be at least a finer target for them arrows and spells, as what I am. Oh, glad you're staying with us. I was going to leave. The investigation of the bandit camp... Ooh, chapter 4. Has directed me to Cloakwood. It appears there is a competing iron mine hidden somewhere deep within the forest. Righto.
Squeaky wheel gets the kick!
Stinking Cloud? Agonar's Scorcher? Horror? And some special kind of...
camaraderie.
Gauntlets.
Adventure. And steel on steel. The stuff of legend. Right, Boo?
Beep. Alright, let's... Look at the stinking cloud. Unidentified gauntlets. Horror is an no, that's necromancy. All enemies within the area of effect when this spell is cast must save versus spell or flee in terror. Certain creatures are immune to the effects of fear, including all undead. And what's this, Agonar's Scorcher, evocation. Upon casting this spell, a jet of flame appears at the caster's fingertips and bursts out towards one target of the caster's choice. That target will be hit by this flame for 3d6 points of damage. The flame jet strikes a second time halfway through its duration, and the caster may move while the spell is in effect. There is no saving throw against this spell, though anti-fire capabilities such as fire resistance will apply and may reduce or eliminate the damage. Okay, so hits the same target. That's pretty sweet. I have some room. I know I don't have that. I have stinking cloud. Not sure if Dinah here does. Do I have horror? Horror, wait a second. So I know the way to look for it. It's weird that it has a heart on it. Level 2. Ghoul touch. Okay. I don't have it. And we'll read those notes. Sweet. Charm person that can go in there. That's enchantment. Yeah, she can't even use it, and I do have it. Stinking cloud. What is it, level 3? 2? She has it, okay. So I'm gonna put it in the scroll case. Alright. Letters from Davion. Tazok, I hope that everything moves along smoothly. I have written to give you instructions from our superiors. I have been told that a small band of mercenaries might cause the Iron Throne some trouble in the future. You're to ensure that they don't live to upset our operations. Obtain the symbols, services of the assassin Nimble. He should serve you well. We've killed Nimble. Okay, so that's that one. Another one from Davion. Tazok, I have noticed that your shipments of iron have slowed of late. It is imperative that we receive another ton of ore. Step up your raids and get a shipment to our base in Cloakwood within the next week. We need to stockpile as much ore as possible before our ultimatum is given. Also, Saravak wants to know what has happened with the band of mercenaries. Have they been killed? You had better ensure that they have been, as Saravak will not take kindly to any other news. Is that the first time we've actually heard that name, Saravak? Okay, so that's that. And then finally, from Borda. Tazok, I demand you pay me the second half of what we agreed upon. The commander only butchering his own family and not half the garrison is not my fault. The Nashkel forces are weakened, and that was the deal. You can send any letters for me to my contact at Nashkel Carnival. I found a merchant desperate enough to buy some of my special potions. He will pass on any letters as well. I wonder if that's the one, the mage that we killed in the tent, who killed that other mage. Make sure we got everything. Quite a lot of money in these containers. We got it all. I wonder if we can rest in here and identify this stuff. Guess we'll give it a try. I've got a ring and these two things. And this harp. It'd be cool if that made it like a little musical harp sound when we picked it up. So four things to identify. Let me just take another peek and see if I might have identified one of these things. Just from lore. Nope. Okay. Yeah. Journal updated. Tazok. You may not rest here. Either find an inn or rest outside. Gonna be attacked?
Sure.
Boo likes the forest.
Why me?
Can we rest in one of these other tents?
All right.
Good on you if you save the day.
Can't rest. Why the hell not?
All right.
Can we rest in the cave? Rested in caves before. Why wouldn't it be any different now?
All right.
The hell? Well, before we do anything,
simple matter.
Sure.
That was a weird sound when he came in here. Almost sounded like Bless rang off, but I didn't cast Bless.
As darkness falls, your mind drifts back to events past, and to triumphs well deserved indeed. A fortified camp secluded and guarded from the entire coast. And it is naught but easy pickings before your guile. All manner of bandit and brigand move about here, but you may as well be invisible amongst them. Your recollections are interrupted by a powerful gust of wind, lifting you high above the camp and woods both. Your arc crests in the high morning sun, and for a moment you are as a bird, free from your duties to those below. With unseen hands, the earth reasserts her hold on you. Suddenly, you feel less like a sparrow and more like a catapult stone.
Oops.
Without impact or fanfare, the ground accepts your passage and does not strike back. In a moment, all is black, and for all you know, you have descended to the very core of the world. The rock around you illuminates, and a cavern slowly takes shape. Though you can see no more than a few steps ahead or behind, stumbling forward, you find yourself face to face with yourself. Before you is a likeness in stone, exact to the smallest detail. A voice in the darkness accuses you, even as it seems amused. Such pride undeserved, great predator, when your whole being is borrowed. Credit where it is due, and dues where payment is demanded. A dagger of bone flies from the blackness and strikes the statue square. It cracks slightly, but the pain you feel is as though you were rent asunder. You were made as you are, taunts the voice, and you can also be broken. You fall backward into the void, and do not come to rest until morning wakes you.
You are made as you are, and you can also be broken. I've gained a new ability for slow poison. Imwin says, good morning, Sapphire. Didn't sound like you slept well last night. Me neither. More dreams, I guess. Yes, another dream. Do you wish to hear it? I do. More daggers and strange voices? Yes, I was in the bandit camp and relaying a dream, etc. That voice scares me, Sapphire. Sounds like it scared you, too. That's good. I don't trust it. Not at all. Nope. I don't. You keep fighting it, Sapphire. I'll help you. If I can. More powers, too, I guess, huh? Yep. I thought so. Well, you just use 'em to do what you know is right. Gryan would like that. Me, too. Guess it doesn't matter where they come from. Come on. I'll fetch you something to eat while you, comb your hair or something. You're a wreck. Where are we gonna get food from one of these tents? Okay, we're full. I now have slow poison. Sweet.
Fine.
And it's fine to me. Oh, wait. We didn't actually rest. Oh, no, wait. Well, we did. Oh, that's right. Yes, we did rest. I was supposed to identify this stuff. Cursed Ring of Slight Monsterism, the Iron Thorn. Oh boy. This wrought iron band is pitted and stained as if by acid. Between the two thorns formed by the band, a crude lump of silver on its head suggests the image of a skull against a black field, perhaps the symbol of Merkel, Lord of Bones. Okay, this changes the wearer's appearance to that of a zombie. Gives you -4 charisma and be only removed by a remove curse spell. As entertaining that sounds, I'd rather just... I wonder if we could sell that. Yeah, put in the gem thing. Okay, we got a longbow. Of marksmanship, the dead shot. Driven by years of rivalry, the Dukes of Sandilion and Del Thuntal decided to organize a private contest that would proclaim the better archer between them. Both boasted the power of their magical bows, but that wasn't enough for the Edwald Dest, Duke of Spandilion. I'm missing a letter here. He arranged for the theft of his opponent's bow, and on the day of the contest, he couldn't help gloat in his advantage. The Duke of Del Thuntal, known only as Raymond, demanded a demonstration of Edwald's skill on a scarecrow that he had placed. Edwald's Dest drew his longbow and released the arrow with determination, not stopping to think how uncannily the target resembled himself. The missile split the large voodoo doll's head in twain, and at that moment, Edwald's head did much the same. That rhymed at the end. The dead shot +2. Now, I don't think... Yeah, unfortunately. Imoran can't use it. Well, it might come in handy. For one of our fighter types. He already has arrows that he's holding for him to win, so might as well. What else we got? Let's check out this harp. Harp of Discord. Even the most talented bard cannot get this harp to play in tune. Each stroke of the harp's strings results in a harsh, off-key note. If the bard attempts to play a proper ballad upon the harp, its magical effects are released. All creatures other than the bard and his or her party must make a saving throw versus a spell or be confused for 30 seconds. Confusion 3 times per day, save versus a spell negates. All within listening range save the bard and fellow party members. Oh, so it is good to use against enemies. Alright. Fortunately, we don't have a bard, so we're just gonna... Oh, it has like 3 charges, I guess. Alright, yeah. We'll sell that. And then finally... Gauntlets of Weapon Expertise, Legacy of the Masters. Sounds promising. Highly sought after among novice warriors, these items were once the property of the royal family of Threshkel. Imparting a portion of the prince's legendary skill, these gauntlets grant the bearer mastery over all forms of weapons. The majority of their many previous owners seem to have come to bloody ends, though. The gloves grant the ability of experience, but not the wisdom. Thaco plus 1, damage plus 2. It's pretty sweet. Who has good gauntlets? He doesn't. Actually, neither of them do. It's me who has it. Sweet. To hit minus 1? Wait a second. So that's good, right? Thaco going down is good. Gets 3 attacks per round? Sweet. Damage. Legacy of the Masters plus 2. Okay, good. Alright. That's it. Not that I'm complaining, mind you. So, oh, she can have another spell. Magic missile, I guess maybe another. Protection from evil, only good against one party member. Shield. Yeah, I guess another magic missile. I can use them more often. Rest again. Sweet. We are good to go. So I guess I'll call it an episode here. Next episode, we're going to come back out, and I guess we're going to kill all these people. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.